Hey now, Rodney Erdickson here, and today I'm going to be showing you how to fix the release date check on the retail version of Grand Theft Auto 4 on PC. Now, important to note that this video will not show you how to circumvent copy protection. That is to say, you still have to own a legal copy of the game and have a legal serial code in order for this fix to work, at least the one I'm showing you in this video. I have no knowledge on how to circumvent copy protection, so don't bother asking. Okay, so here we go. Grand Theft Auto 4 release date check. I'm connected to the internet. I'm going to click next. Now, I've been testing this for about a week now, and unfortunately, as of this date of recording, the Grand Theft Auto 4 release date check no longer functions. See, I'm being told that Grand Theft Auto 4 has been successfully installed. That's great, but here we go. Grand Theft Auto 4 release date check. I just gave access to the secure ROM security program in order to complete the release date check, and as you can see, it reads Grand Theft Auto 4 release date check. Please wait until the online release date check has completed 30% complete. Now we wait, and what happens? We receive this. Grand Theft Auto 4 release date check failure. An error occurred during the release date check. Click the retry button to check again. Internet connection required. Well, I do have an internet connection, so let's try again. I see activity on my firewall. So, theoretically, this should work, right? As of recently, the answer is no. This will systematically fail over and over, and it seems there is no way around it. Now, if you click on the link, activate rockstargames.com GTA 4. You might receive this error. Secure connection failed. An error occurred during connection to support securerom.com. Cannot communicate securely with peer. No common encryption algorithms. Error code SSL error. No cipher overlap. Okay, if you receive this error, your browser that you're using is not new enough in order to view the website. You need one with a very high security algorithm. The newest version of Google Chrome should solve this problem. So you can alternatively use activate.rockstargames.com/?C=GTA4, or you can use https://support.securerom, that's securerom.com/rockstarunlock/?C=GTA4. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this web link and I'm going to paste it in Google Chrome. And all of a sudden, the website works. So, if you have episodes from Liberty City, you click on this one. If you have Grand Theft Auto 4, you click on this one. Now, this page isn't terribly clear. You have offline date check and product activation, manual product activation, manual product revocation, secure ROM, component information, removal process guide, and additional support info. I recommend you click on the link under offline date check and product activation guide. This is regardless if you have an active internet connection or not. You click on that link. Is this the right one? Yes, it is. Okay, so ideally what you're going to do is you can follow the instructions if you so wish. However, if you have an active internet connection on the computer you're activating Grand Theft Auto 4 on, I recommend you just do as I am showing. You scroll all the way down to the yellow text that reads, right-click here and save as option to download the file. So I'm going to right-click and save link as. It reads GTA IVPC_offline installer.zip. This is what I'm going to save. It's going to save right now. I'm also going to copy the link address. What I'm going to try to do is I'm going to try to put this in the description field of this video, below this video window. And this way, if this link works on its own, you could use this link without going through the trouble of downloading Chrome and using Chrome and going through all this rigmarole if you do not have Chrome. Okay, so GTA 4 PC offline installer.zip was downloaded. So what you do from that point, this is what reasons why I don't like Chrome. Where is it? It's in downloads. Okay. Gonna extract here. What you have here is GTA4RC.exe. This is the file you need. Now, if you have gone through the efforts of going through, all of this activation, then chances are, if you're clicking on activate manually or retry, you're stuck on this window anyway. You're stuck on the Grand Theft Auto 4 release date check failure window, even though you went through the activate manually steps. If you're like me in this example and have just newly installed the game, if you don't activate manually, what I'm showing you will fix the problem. Either way, if you activate manually, going through all the steps shown on this website in order, or if you have not activated manually and you just want to activate using the internet the way it used to work, then once again, the file we just downloaded will solve the problem. So, in this example, you could just cancel this. Do you want to cancel the release date check? Yes. Grand Theft Auto 4 has been successfully installed. Very good. Finish. No problem. And now what you're going to do is you are going to run GTA 4 RC. As simple as that. Although something is loading in the background. Just want to launch Social Club or exit. Just going to exit. Okay. So here we go. You simply run GTA 4 RC. License agreement, blah, blah, blah. I agree. Setup was completed successfully. Good. Close. It should be loading. Nope. Maybe at this point I just run Grand Theft Auto 4. There we go. As you can see, the activation window is completely different than what you saw prior. This software must be authenticated online prior to use. For activation, a valid serial and an active internet connection is required. Now keep in mind, this page, you are not going to see this page if you went through the steps of the manual registration. If you did the manual registration successfully after you run that GTA4RC.exe file, this window won't show up. Your game will just run as intended. However, if you have not done the manual activation, which I do not recommend you do because there's a lot of things that could go wrong, especially in taking note of and copying, pasting, and keeping track of the three serial numbers you need. Yes, three. Not just the one you have on your little leaflet inside the jewel case. So I'm going to do next here. And here we go. Unlock request code. Don't pay attention to this. Yours will differ. Yours will not be the same as mine. So don't bother copying this. This won't help you. You'll need to put in your valid serial. And in this case, if you have this window, you click on activate. And unlike the previous release date check that you saw prior, in this case, this step will function as intended. Now, extremely important, before I let you go, there's not much more to tell you. Once you put in your proper serial and click on activate, this system will work and your game will work as intended. Just extremely, extremely important. I cannot stress this enough. The way the whole release date check system works, unlike Steam games, your Grand Theft Auto 4 game associated to your serial can only work on one machine. That is to say, if you have two machines and you install it on both machines, the game cannot be actively functional on both machines. That whole release date check and activation can only be active on one machine. Now, why am I stressing this? I'm stressing this because if you are going to change computers, if you are going to change hard drives, if you are going to upgrade your computer, if you're going to change your operating system, if you are simply going to delete the game, or if you fear that your hard drive's on its last leg and is infected with viruses and or will become corrupt and die or what have you, insert reason here, you must revocate your activation. What this does is this frees up your license so that you could install the game on a different computer. If you don't do this and you simply try to install the game on a different computer and run it without having revocated the license from the previous install on the previous computer, that's why it's such a pain, then your game will not be activatable and will not run. That's why, if you're done with Grand Theft Auto 4, your install of it, and you want to get rid of it before formatting your drive or disassembling your computer or what have you, it's extremely important that you go to Start Programs, Rockstar Games, Grand Theft Auto 4, Revoke License. And you must go through the steps in order to obtain confirmation that your license is successfully revoked. This does function as intended over the internet as of this date of recording. Of course, if you need to do this offline, there is a how-to guide, manual product revocation guide here. Once again, same website I showed earlier. And that'll take you through the steps on how to do it manually. Once again, if you do it manually, you will need to download another program on the computer that has internet access, as well as you'll have to take note of the three different serial numbers I told you about prior. You'll need to take note of them. I recommend copying and pasting them into a text file and moving that text file about using a USB key, because actually writing them out or printing them out or what have you, there could be discrepancies where you don't quite understand what you have written out or copied. What you have written out, excuse me, or have copied out. Well, there you go. I'll leave you with that. I hope this information helps, and as usual, all the best.